Welcome back to Options Insight. My name is Imran Lakha, and today's episode is all about options jargon busting. So, financial markets are notorious for having lots of strange jargon that the professionals in the industry use and the average layman wouldn't really understand. And that's quite intimidating and quite confusing for a lot of people. So I'm here to kind of hopefully clear up some of the most common terms that we use when we talk about options. And hopefully that will help you in future episodes to understand what I'm talking about and will just kind of make things a little bit less confusing. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is vanilla.
What do you mean?
Vanilla options are just basic options. So calls and puts, as in what we've described in previous videos, that's basic options. They are the most basic types of options. And you know, they're usually commoditized, they trade on exchanges, and they're easy to get prices and liquidity for, okay? What's the next term? Derivative. What is a derivative? Well, an option is a type of derivative. And a derivative is just a product or a contract that derives its value from a different underlying asset. And that underlying asset could be a commodity like oil or gold. It could be a currency like the pound or the euro, or it could be a security, which is another fancy name for a stock or a bond. The next term is expiry and maturity. So when we talk about an options expiry or an options maturity, that's because, like we've said, calls and puts are the right to buy or sell an underlying asset. But that right, you don't have that right forever. When you buy an option, it has to have an expiry date or a maturity date, as we call it. And after that date, you will no longer have the option. So that's what we're talking about, basically. So when you talk about options, you always ask the question, what's the expiry of that option? And that option will cease to exist after that expiry date passes. The next term, exercise. When you decide to actually use your option to buy or option to sell, and you go ahead and actually buy or sell that stock, that is called exercising your option. So you can exercise that option either on the expiry date, or in some cases you can exercise that option at any time between the day you bought that option and the expiry date, and we'll talk a bit more about that later. Strike price. What do we mean by strike price? Well, that's actually the transaction price. If you do choose to exercise your option, then that is the price you will transact at. So if I have a call option, which is an option to buy, and I exercise my option to buy, the price that I buy my underlying asset at is the strike price. And then the last one, premium. That's just the price you pay for an option. So like we've discussed before, if you buy an option, you have to pay for it. The price you pay for an option is the premium. If you sell the option, then you receive the premium, right? So the premium, again, another fancy word just for the price. And that's the first group of basic terms for options. Okay, so the next group of terms that I want to talk about are related to expiry and strikes. So when we talk about expiry, there are actually a couple of different types of expiries that you can have in options. So you can have American expiring options, and that's not only options that expire in the US, for example. What American expiry means is that you can exercise the option anytime between now, like as in once you've bought it, up until the expiry date. So it's not only on one specific date or time that you can exercise it, you can do it at any time between now and when it expires. The type of options that tend to be American expiry are single stocks or ETF options. And you know, a lot of the options in the US, like ETFs is a massive market in the US, so they happen to be American expiries. European expiry options, on the other hand, they only have a specific time and date that they can be exercised on. And you tend to find European options more like index options. So when, for example, on one of the broad indices like the S&P 500 or the FTSE or the DAX, for example, options on those tend to be European style expiry. So now when we talk about strikes of an option, obviously you could talk about the specific strike price, but that will depend on what stock or index you're talking about. So the more general terms that are used when you talk about strikes are at the money, which is ATM, out the money, and in the money. So for an option to be at the money, the strike has to be equal to where the underlying price currently is. So for example, if you have an option on Apple stock, and Apple stock's trading at, who knows, $400, a $400 strike, call or put is considered an at the money option. An out of the money option, on the other hand, is when the strike price is away from the current price, such that you, if it was to expire today, you would never exercise it because it's worthless. So obviously an out of the money option, for example, a call option, which we know is a right to buy. If you've got a right to buy a stock, say Apple again, if the stock's at 400 and you have the right to buy it at 500, you're never gonna do that. So an upside call option is an out of the money option because you would not exercise that option. However, if the strike of that call option was 300 and the stock's trading at 400, then you would exercise that. And that means it's an in the money option, right? So in the money and out of the money. It depends on whether it's the right to buy or sell, and it depends on where that underlying asset is relative to that strike. And then lastly, downside and upside. Pretty straightforward. A downside option, usually the ones that are downside options that are traded heavily are puts, because the price of the strike price is below the underlying price. So for strikes that are below the current price, they're called downside puts or downside options. You can trade downside calls, but they don't tend to trade very much because they're a lot more expensive because they're in the money options, right? Downside puts, however, are generally out of the money options, and therefore, when we talk about downside, we're generally talking about puts. On the upside, flip side of that argument is upside calls, right? Upside calls are generally going to be the out of the money options, and it's out of the money options that tend to trade in the highest volume. So when we talk about strikes that are above the current underlying price, we're talking about upside. And that's the basic options trading jargon that I wanted to go over. Thanks so much for watching my jargon busting video. I hope you found it useful. If there's any other terms that you're not sure about, please write them in the comment section of the video and I will get back to you. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and if you want to learn more about my training services, please visit optionsinsight.com. Thanks for watching.